Thousands of people in South Florida are cleaning up after taking a direct hit from Tropical Storm Eta. Strong winds and heavy rain forced evacuations. According to the National Weather Service, the storm system dumped more than 13 inches of rain in some parts of the state. Rain from Eta had already caused catastrophic flooding in parts of Central America last week. It was one of the most powerful storms to hit the region in decades, killing more than 150 people. CBS News meteorologist and climate specialist Jeff Berardelli joins me now. Hi, Jeff. So Eta is beginning to move away from Florida, but the impact continues. Where is she heading and what's the latest?
All right, so the storm is moving west, which means that it's drying out across a lot of South Florida, which is good news because they are waterlogged. Take a look at how much rain fell. So this right here is Alligator Alley, and this is Fort Lauderdale. So in between Fort Lauderdale and Miami, right around Miramar, Weston, foot of rain fell with this system. Now, that may not seem like a lot, but so far this year, they've had 80, 90, up to 100 inches of rain in South Florida. One of, if not the wettest years on record. They certainly did not need that rainfall. Again, the good news is Eta is moving out. And by the way, it's weakening. The winds are only 50 miles an hour right now. There will continue to be showers and very humid air in South Florida. But again, things are moving to the west right now, which is good news. And as it continues to move to the west, things will start to improve. That's a look at the satellite. So there's really not much left of it, but it actually still has a chance of invigorating and getting stronger, believe it or not, over the next couple of days. So yeah, there's a chance it could re-intensify, Tanya.
So, you know, Jeff, as we've discussed before, 2020 has been a record-breaking hurricane season. Is this it? Is it over? Please say so. Or is there more to come?
Unfortunately, there's more to come. So let's talk more about this system first and show you the track. So we expect it to move west-southwest and then probably move northeast. And remember, the Masters tournament's actually starting Thursday into Sunday in Georgia. So this could throw a wrinkle into that. We don't expect it necessarily to get much stronger, but it's going to be lurking just offshore, making people nervous off the Tampa Bay area to the west of the Tampa Bay area and in the Panhandle. Now, the computer model forecasts are literally everywhere. Some go southwest. Some go west, some go north. The National Hurricane Center forecast goes northeast. So we're not sure exactly where this is going to go yet. And here's the reason why. So there's a jet stream driving its way to the south here. And there's high pressure clockwise flow here in the western Gulf of Mexico. So is this storm right here going to get caught by high pressure and brought back south? That's possible. Is it going to get picked up by the jet stream and brought north? That's possible. Is it going to get steered by this ridge of high pressure, the Bermuda High? That's possible. We don't know. It's going to be stuck in no man's land for a couple of days. So just to give you an idea of the question you asked. So Eta is the 12th named system to make landfall in the U.S. The old record was 9. So that's an incredible record. Last time this happened, a tropical storm making landfall in Florida was in November. In the month of November was Mitch, 1998. And so far, we've had 28 tropical storms, which ties for the most records, which was back in 2005. But before that, the most on record was 20, set back in 1933. We are up to 28, and yes, 29 and 30 are on their way, maybe pretty quickly. So there's a 50% chance of development. That could become Iota. So that would be the first time we've ever had an Iota. And then there's a chance of Theta forming. That should form first. 80% chance that that'll form out in the Central Atlantic. Neither one of these look to be a threat to the United States. But we'll get to 30 within about the next few days. And then we still have another few weeks left in 2020. So think about it. The record before 2005 was 20 storms back in 1933. We're likely to get to 31, 32 this year. Warm ocean temperatures.
Incredible.
That's one of the reasons.
Incredible. Jeff Berardelli, thank you once again. We really appreciate it.
You're welcome.